Come on into my studio. Welcome, everybody. Today we're going to be doing this scenery of kind of a stream, springtime, maybe summer, could be whatever you want. This is just a made-up one, so there's no traceable. So get your stuff ready and paint along with me. See you in a bit. Okay, so I'm going to use some masking fluid in this one, and I haven't shown you how I do this in other streams. And what I like to do is use these, they're like a scraper of some sort. They're used in clay, actually, but you can get ones for mixed media, and they clean up really nice. Nothing sticks to it. And you can get them with fine points, different shapes, different sizes. So I just got mine on Amazon. You can pretty well get them anywhere. Not acrylic. What are they called? Silicone. That's it. I knew I'd think of it. They're pretty available anywhere. So what I've done here is I've just basically mapped in an area of where I want my little hills or meadow and some trees and the stream. And I'm just masking in this one set of trees that's sitting in the back a little bit. And they're going to be birch trees. So I want to be able to just do a quick wash in the background without having to worry about painting in between. So I'm just working in my sketchbook, and this isn't a watercolor paper, so if you want to use watercolor paper, that's great. I just use my sketchbook, and I like doing this. It's not multi-layers, very quick, so I don't really need the watercolor paper for what I do. A lot of times I do a lot of line drawing on it too. So I'm just using a very, very light wash of cobalt blue, very watered down, so just to get a bit of a sky on the top there. And now I'm using some Payne's Gray, and this is a Terry Harrison foliage brush, I believe they call it. And I didn't wet it, but I dipped it in the Payne's Gray and a little bit of Da Vinci leaf green. And now I put a little bit of water on the bottom of that and let it seep up. And that way it kind of gives it a little bit of a foggy appearance. So this is the back meadow. So there's not a whole lot of detail. It's more about color combinations of blotches in the background. So they would be more long, like horizontal and narrow as far as depth is concerned. And the further you get closer to you, then they get a little bit larger. So the depth gets wider and bigger. So I also put in a little bit of yellow ochre. Because there would be, you know, different shades of types of plants and bushes and all sorts of things growing in there. If it's a wild field, then there's all kinds of stuff. Bulrushes, different types of grasses. And along the stream here, you would get all kinds of long grass, bulrushes. Pampas grass is another thing you see along the edge. All kinds of different water plants. but I'm not worried about being exact as far as what they look like. It's just the suggestion that I'm painting. Because it's a landscape, a distant landscape, you're not going to get that fine detail. So here's a hill that I'm going to be putting in. And it's a little closer to us, so it would be a little more darker. And I'm going to be putting a tree in there also. So I'm thinking of that as far as shadows, and I knew that that tree would be casting shadows below it. So that's why I'm using the darker greens. And I believe that's Daniel Smith's Green Appetite Genuine, I think it is. And I just took a little bit out with a cloth to lighten that area a little bit. And I'm using that foliage brush again because it's very hairy, I guess you could say. It doesn't, when you wet it, it doesn't stick together. Doesn't form a nice chiseled edge. It's always splayed apart. And it's great for foliage, for grasses, all that type of thing. There, I'm putting some grasses in, and you always have to remember your along the water there, you have to put your reflection in. So with the same color and the same action that I'm using, I put the grasses in the opposite direction. Now I haven't put in any of like blue water or anything yet, but you can tell that this is water. And I just put in a little bit of cobalt blue in those little areas that were left. Not much, because a lot of the reflection will give you the color on top of the water. So I've decided to take up a little bit of this paint. And this paper's pretty good considering it's just a sketchbook. But I was able to lift it a bit. So I'm thinking about a little bit more color. So it was kind of flat looking. So just a little bit more color to give a form to some of those bushes or whatever it is that's on the bank. And then remembering to put the same thing in as the reflection in the water. And a little bit darker along the edge of the water also. Because that's where the shadows would be, and if it's dirt, it would be dark. I hope you guys will try this. It's very, very beginner friendly, and just make something up or search for water scenes in Google, or if you can, if there's a waterways around you, go down there and take a look. Take a picture. You don't have to be there and do it, but take a picture and then come back and see what you can do with it. And you don't have to put everything in. If you don't like some trees, leave them out. Putting some more grasses in here just to make it a little more interesting. A little darker this time. So I added a little bit of burnt umber to that green mix to make it a little bit darker. You could also add Payne's Gray to darken it. If you want it more on the olive side, then put a little bit of red added to that green mix. So these grasses right here are a little bit closer to me So you would notice things a little more as far as detail. So I'm making those a little bit more noticeable, and I will go back and add a few leaves and that type of thing. Again, but very generic leaves. They don't, you can't say that's a such and such. It's just generic. Little more of that ochre color. So very limited palette here. Just basically Payne's gray, ochre, and green. Oh, and a little bit of blue for the sky. Here's the little leaves, so just little dabs with my I think that's a number two silver black velvet round. There, I'm adding some more shadow. And I'll add some reeds to it too. Or grass, whatever that is. This brush is so great, and I did check to see if it's available, and you can still buy them. And they're the any of the foliage brushes or brushes for trees. They have a website. You can get them singly or in sets. Now I'm putting in some trees, and this is Payne's gray and burnt umber to make it really, really dark, almost black. So I'm just putting the trunk in, and then I'll add the foliage afterwards. So they're very short looking. You may think it looks weird, but I have a method to my madness. Here's the foliage brush again. So watch how quick and easy this is to make foliage. It's a real game changer for me. So I'm starting off basically with Daniel Smith Green Appetite Genuine. And it was a wet into wet. So I don't want to fill it all up with green. So there are areas that it will be, you'll see the paper through it. And adding a little bit darker here and there for shadows. Here's the tree that's on that bank. So this brush is also an excellent brush for acrylic painting if you're interested in acrylic painting. And I do the acrylics on Thursdays at 1 Eastern PM. So I added a little bit of a couple different greens here and a little yellow. I think that's Hensa yellow that I'm using there. Just brightens up some of the areas, gives a little more depth. So quick and easy. So now I'm taking off that masking fluid. I bet you forgot I did that. You could have just left them without. It didn't have to go in there, but I wanted to try it to see if it would work on the scrap or sketch paper, and it does quite well. Adding a few bushes around the trees with a little bit of a darker color, because you would have shading, and a few darker areas in this tree here because it would be more shaded than the other one, especially in the bottom area. In a few more areas of the trunk of the tree, darkening it a little bit, and putting in some of the limbs. So as you can see, this is very quick and easy, very simple, no multi-layering here. But it's very effective. See, and I just put a few limbs that are peeking through the gaps in the holes in the leaf area. So take a look at your trees when you're looking at trees in a park or in your yard. Notice where you can see the limbs. You can put in as much as you want. You could have it a lot more sparse if you wanted to and make it more early spring. Or you could make this into a fall one and adding your oranges and reds. They're fun to make. I really like doing them. You could have a duck in there too. That would be cute. Decided to put a little bit of dots around representing shadowed areas in between the leaves, type of thing. A few more of those bulrushes. There's the silicone. It's got a really chisel edge to it, so I thought it would be kind of cool to see if I could make the marks that are dark on the birch trees. I think it turned out kind of cool. I think I'll probably do painting of just birch trees. I do love them. I have quite a few in my yard. So here I'm wetting the area and just lifting a little bit of this black out on one side just to give it a little bit of a highlight. Instead of it just being plain black, just gives it a little bit more interest. Gives it more dimension. And there we are. So a lot of that background was covered, but you know, it's all practice. And being that this was just a made-up scenery, I didn't know what the end result was going to be. So just checking over and see if there's anything I missed that might need touching up or maybe enhancing a little bit. So I decided to put a little bit of a darker background there. Give that feel a little bit more dimension. And then I put a little bit of shadow kind of in the background there, so the bank of trees would have a little bit more color. And then too, if it's a little darker, those white birch trees will show up a little bit more. So adding a little bit more shadows in those trees. There's so many ways of doing different trees, and you could also, you know, get into the folk art type of thing and doing the stylized trees. They're really fun to do. I've done a few folk art paintings, landscapes like that with the bunny in front and that type of thing. I think I'd like to try it in watercolor. I think it would be really easy doing those soft looking hills that go from light to dark. So maybe we'll try some of those. What do you guys think? Would you like to try some of those too? So just a bunch of dots. That makes the just around the bottom or where I've done the little bit of shading. Then you do a bunch of little dots just above it, slightly above it, and it just gives it a really nice look. All right, there we are. And I hope you have a fantastic day. See you soon.